Shougata, good morning. Sorry to be troubling you early morning, but wanted to get your analysis on what's happening on the CPI side, Shougata.
What did
you make of the breakup?
I thought you're a bit dire there. I mean, you'll really scare the bond market. So
really?
No. It's not that bad. I mean, initially our forecast was 4.5, so we were a little bit better than the market. And it came in as a surprise at 4.9. But remember that 29% of this 4.9 is from two commodities, tomatoes and onions. 29%. So 1.4 as a contribution to that 4.9. I know we do this jugglery, and I know that the RBI is not, the MPC probably is not convinced that, this is this time, that is that time, and so on. So what we are focusing on the headline. But the point is that, with 29% of this contribution to this thing coming in from two commodities, and these are commodities which are likely to retrace back in the next couple of months. So it's not going to be that bad. I mean, our sense is that we'll probably get another 4.7% for the month of December. But finally, I think inflation will come in into that 4.3 to 4.7 range in Q4 that the Reserve Bank, that the RBI statement talked about. So it's not completely out it was a surprise. I mean, we hadn't anticipated that big a jump in vegetable prices. But that's the bottom line from this.
Shougata, did the bond market already anticipate this? We've seen yields go up.
I have a feeling. There was talk in the market that inflation would come in at 4.7.
Okay.
There was chatter in the market. So I think a whole bunch of factors contributed to the sharp rise in yields. I think the illiquidity premium from the old paper, the rise in oil prices, etc. So I think a whole bunch, and then the Fed, the Federal Reserve, the U.S. yields rising another 2 basis points or something. So all of them came together, but I have a sense that, yes, the market somehow anticipated.
So you would that expect another move up in yields based on this CPI number?
I think that's something that you can expect. Of course, the Reserve Bank has come out with the auction of the FPI limits. And that's something I guess that they would have to do. Normally, this is done at the end of the quarter. But this came in yesterday. So I think, even with that, I think there will be a slight bearish tone in the bond markets.
Okay. Quick word on IIP, Shougata. Anything notable there?
IIP notable, yes. I mean, good and bad news. We got that one very right. I mean, 2.2%. So that was anticipated. But the internals of the IIP, was peculiar. For one, the slowdown came in largely from the mining sector, as you would have seen. We had anticipated 3% growth. We got a 0% flat growth. So that's one thing. I think that's to do with the untimely rains. I think that they interfered with mining. But the 7.7 consumer non-durables growth, which people are trumpeting about, if you factor in if you take out the antibiotics and the medication and antibiotics component that has become very volatile. Digestives and antacids.
Not the biscuits, I'm sure.
Yes.
Stop
eating outside. So if you take that out, so that's not good news, because then consumer non-durables, FMCG, is actually -1.1. So good and bad in the IIP, but this was anticipated, I think, because of the festival season. I mean, don't take this one very seriously. It did around the festival season and so on. That's always you need to take a moving average of 2 or 3 months. So let's see what the next one comes in about. But it's not terrible. I mean, the overall mix of these two numbers, it's not as dire as...
Shougata, if it wasn't for tomato, onions and we'd all be in a better place.
Yeah.
Before we say goodbye here this morning, I want to sneak in a quick question. This is Menka here.
Yes, ma'am.
I know there is no direct correlation between what we're seeing in the US and what we're seeing in India.
Right.
But if you track producer prices in the US last night,
right,
we got a larger than anticipated increase.
Right.
And most people are attributing that to the back of fuel prices. So my large question to you really is, that is the known unknown, right, for the next 12 months from here on, commodity and fuel prices, so to speak, the upturn that we're seeing.
Right.
Sufficiently worrisome enough for you, or worrisome is maybe a strong word, but for you to think that the door has firmly closed now on any potential rate cut by the RBI, and if anything, either we look at a status quo from here onwards, or maybe even a move up?
So for one thing, the first question, the correlation, I think this is definitely the effect of fuel prices, energy prices. I'm not totally pessimistic about oil prices moving up and up and up. I mean, these may be the last words of a wise economist. But having said this, I think that gap between the WTI and Brent that had opened up in the last month, I think that is beginning to close. Mm. And once that happens, I think shale will come in. So you're not going to go back down towards that 55 range, not before the winter's end in the West. But I think more or less prices on energy are capped. I'm not very sure about metals prices. Metals prices might rise a little bit more, but maybe just about 5-10%, not more than that. So I'm not completely, not totally pessimistic about commodities prices. But having said this, look, anyway, even before, we were anticipating something like a 25 cut from the Reserve Bank. It's a very, very shallow cut. So it's not as if, that might have been a little opportunity for some traders, but nothing to do with the real world. I mean, in the real world, there's nothing that is happening. I think liquidity needs to be tracked very carefully, the effect on market interest rates, overnight rates, near-term rates, and then on to the medium-term rates. I think that needs to be tracked. And even there, I mean, you'll see a tightening of liquidity in this quarter and spilling over into the next quarter. But I think there's ample liquidity, latent liquidity available in the market. I mean, 2 lakh crores, 2 trillion worth of forwards are going to mature over the next year. About 1 lakh crores, 1 trillion of the market stabilization scheme, that's likely to mature. So I think liquidity will be more and less ample. It's not going to be a huge problem, and the Reserve Bank will come in. I think we'll continue to keep, if not at the magnitude that we had before, FPI flows. So my sense is rate hikes for the next year and a half are out of the question. I think growth is far too fragile. Yes, sir. At this point in time. So rate hikes is out of the question, but rate cuts, yes, I agree with you that, I mean, the probability that we had ascribed 20-25% of a rate cut, I think is more or less gone for the time being.